Finally, we'll follow an application developer. This is a developer who is building an app which needs a source of events. And rather than have to set this up for themselves, they're going to start by looking in their organization's catalog to see what event sources have been shared and made available for use. And if they find something useful, they can create themselves a unique set of credentials for their app through the self-service developer portal. We'll start by creating credentials. Our app developer can create an app in the developer portal that represents the application that they're going to be building. This will give them a new and unique set of credentials that they can use for any of the APIs that they find in this catalogue. Now, it's important that they make a copy of the key and secret that are generated for their application now, because as it's a password, the secret can't be retrieved again later. Now they have some credentials, they're ready to start looking for sources of events. In this demo, as you've seen, our Kafka topic owners have only published a single Kafka topic into a single product. So this developer portal is looking a little bare. In a real organization, over time, this catalog would be filled out with a variety of different groups of APIs and filled with different Kafka topics. And our app developer would be able to browse and search through all of them. But for now, they can just click through to the only published Kafka topic. This shows them the documentation that has been prepared by the Kafka topic owner, the description of the topic and the events that are being published to it. They can't see the connection details for the real Kafka cluster, but they can see the address of the event gateway service that will allow them managed and secured access to it. There are links to more info about Async API and about Kafka, in case they're new to Kafka. They can click through to see sample code for how to consume the events on the topic in a variety of languages. And they can get the connection details that they would need to configure an existing Kafka application or tool to consume from this topic. And they can get detailed information about the messages on the topic, the different fields that are in the messages, what type of data they contain, whether they're required or optional, and so on. And finally, they can see an example of what messages on this topic look like. In short, this page has everything that our app developer needs to help them identify whether or not this stream of events would be useful for the application that they're building. So let's assume that it is. So they decide they want to get access to this topic. So they click on the Get Access button in the top right. They can choose if there are different plans available, different sets of limitations and restrictions, which plan they think is appropriate. And they can choose which of the applications they're building they want to use this Kafka topic for. But that is all they need to do. After confirming their choices, they have, through a self-service way, been able to get themselves access to this new Kafka topic without needing to contact or talk to the Kafka topic owner. Finally, let's see how easy it is for our app developer to use the stream of events that they now have access to. If they're building a new app, the sample code in the portal is a great way to get started. They can just copy this code and paste it into their favorite Java IDE. And this code is almost ready to compile and run as is. There's just a couple of things they need to finish off. First, they need to paste in their own unique and private password. This is the secret that was generated for them earlier when they created their app. And finally, they need to add in their own business logic. They need to get their application to do something with the events that their app receives. Now, for the purposes of this demo, I'm going to paste in a few simple lines of code that will print out the contents of the events that the application receives. And with that, their application is now ready to run. And if I run it, you'll see the events start to appear in the console. In a few minutes, our app developer went from discovering that this source of Kafka events was available to having their own working, running application code able to receive them. Using credentials that are unique to their application that they created for themselves through a self-service portal. I showed you Java for this demo, but templates for other programming languages and tools are also available. And there are loads of other client libraries and tools that support Kafka, so the app developer can always use the connection properties table below to use any of them instead. Finally, I mentioned earlier that all of this is defined and described using the Open Async API standard. So the application developer can download this Async API documentation for use with tools that support this emerging standard. For example, the open source, low-code, flow-based development tool Node-RED can use Async API documents to configure nodes. Now in the current version of the Async API spec, which is version 2.0, this doesn't capture security config. So our application developer will need to go in to the node and add these security parameters for themselves. But in the next week or so, the new version of the spec, 2.1, adds support for identifying the Kafka security mechanism and protocols. And that will mean that this can automatically be configured from the async API spec directly. And then all they'll have to do is to add their application credentials. And by doing this and running this flow, they'll immediately start to see events appear in their debug console over here. Whether they want to build a new application or configure an existing application or tool, Event Endpoint Management allows our app developer to discover sources of events that are available to them and to quickly start using them.